dear students, today we are going to see about chapter 1, exercise number 1.4, data and information. Before we are going to discuss about the topic, now I am going to show the first digital computer in the world. The name is ENIAC. Children, you just see the picture. This is the world's first digital computer. Students, just see the machine. It should be looks like a factory or laboratory or else somewhat very big electrical room like that, right? This is a computer, first digital computer. The name is ENIAC. The term ENIAC stands for Electronic Numerical Integrator and Calculator. Okay, this is a expansion of ENIAC. It was invented by J. Presper Eckert and John McCauley. These are the two persons are invented by this machine ENIAC at the University of Pennsylvania and began construction in the year 1943, and it was not completed until 1946. That means for the past, during this period, they have to construct it. This machine occupied about how much space? We just know that 1800 square feet, and it used about 18,000 vacuum tubes. In the first generations of computers, we already discussed which main components are used. Vacuum tubes alone, right? So this is the first digital computer in the year 1943 to 1946. So that period, the main component is what? Vacuum tubes. And this machine weight is almost 50 tons. That is the weight of the particular digital computer. ENIAC was the first digital computer because it was fully functional. Fully functional means this is a successive version of the digital computer in the period of 1943 to 1946. Okay, so this is information regarding about the first digital computer. The name is what? ENIAC. That means Electronic Numerical Integrator and Calculator. Don't forget, my dear students. Right, now today we are going to start 1.4, data and information. So we already know about what is computer. Yeah, tell me, what is computer? Yes, it is an electronic device that processes the input according to the set of instructions provided to it and gives the desired output at a very faster rate. So this is a definition of computer, and it is one of the very versatile machine. It will do a lot of different tasks such as weather forecasting, booking tickets, railway, movie tickets, everything. And we have to do e-commerce activities and banking transactions and storing data, even playing games, etc., etc. Nowadays we are doing, with the help of this machine, we have to do a lot of different tasks. Am I right? Yes. So this is the information regarding about computer. Now we are going to see about what is data and what is information. First of all, in our computer, we have to store the data. All of you agree this point? Yes. So what is data? That is my question. So what is data? Data is defined as an unprocessed collection of raw facts. Data means what? An unprocessed collection of raw fact. That is known as data. And it is suitable for communication, interpretation, or processing. For what purpose? For what purpose we have to use the data? For communication, interpretation, or processing. Okay? Yes. For example, here I gave some information. Sorry. Some example. Here 1, 3, 4. It is a numerical value. And next one, 1, 6. The next one, I gave one name. One girl name, right? And the next one, alphabet C. So these all are considered as a data. Y means this is unprocessed collection of raw fact. Is this have any meaningful? You just read the example. Is this have any meaningful word or meaningful sentence? No. 1, 3, 4, 1, 6, C and some name is there, right? So this is not a meaningful one. Yes. So this is called data. So generally, whatever the data you have to give to the computer, that time the data should be considered as unprocessed collection of raw fact. Okay. It does not give any information. Okay. Right. The next definition about information. So what is information? Information is nothing but it is a collection of fact from which conclusions may be drawn. So information means what? It is a collection of fact from which conclusions may be drawn. In simple word, we can say that data is the raw fact. That data should be processed to give meaningful or ordered or structured information. So that means what? Already we discussed, data means what? It is a unprocessed collection of raw fact. So once the data should be processed means that processed data should be considered as what? Information. That information is a meaningful one. Understood? So information is only give the meaningful sentence or words or whatever it is, not data. Data means it's just raw fact of data or raw fact of unprocessed collection of facts like that. Okay, so that is data. But information means it is a collection of fact from which conclusions may be drawn finally. That is known as what? Information. For example, here, the same, the previous slide, I mentioned, right? 1, 3, 4 and 1, 6 and one girl name and one alphabet like that. Now, you have to see that this is not a meaningful message, but the next title, information, the same thing. Now, for example, Kavita is 16 years old. So now this sentence give some meaningful information. So this is known as what? Information. So students, did you understand what is data and what is information? So both these data and information, these ones, the data should be processed means we have to get information. Then only that information have a meaningful message. So these process is known as data processing. Okay, this conversion of data into information is called what processing? Data processing. So data processing means what? Once the data should be processed or conversion into or converted into information, that process is known as what? Data processing. Don't forget. Okay, all right. See that diagram here in our computer. This is the action. Whenever we have a data to the computer, automatically it will be do like that. So a computer is an electronic device that takes raw data. That means unprocessed data as an what? Input. So whatever the unprocessed data we have to give to the computer, that should be called as what? Input. So that input, whom to be give? User. Only the user. So who will be the user? Who and all work with computer, that people should call as what? User. So the user give the input and process it under the control of set of instructions. That is called what? Program. So one program only do the set of instructions or set of actions and it produce a result. That result should be called as what? Output. Okay. And we have to save for our future use. So this is action. Okay, so this is a process should happen. Once you give the data to the computer, then it will be processed, then it will be produced the result. This is the action. So I just mentioned the diagrammatic representations regarding about the process. The first thing is input you have to give to the computer, then computer receive all the inputs from the user and immediately it just do the process. In that process, the data conversion is going on. Then after this process complete, it will be produced the result. That result should be called as what? Output. Okay, right. So these all the actions are happening with the help of what? This data processing. So in this data processing, the main component is what? Data. So once this data processing is complete means we have to get what? Information. Okay, so this is a pictorial representation of data processing. All of you understand, my dear students? Yes. Right. The next topic, 1.5, components of computer. So what are the different components of computers are available in our computer, especially? So computer, already we know, it is electronic device, right? So mainly, the computer is the combination of both hardware and software. Both hardware and software means then will be called as what? Computer. Hardware and software. Do you know the difference? Yeah, you just know the information regarding about that. What is hardware? Hardware is the physical components of a computer like motherboard, memory devices, monitor, keyboard, etc., etc., like that. Okay, so generally, hardware means just call as physical components. So what are the physical components? You have to see in front of you that devices all are called as hardware devices. So especially which one is hardware means you can touch and feel. You can touch and feel and see. You can see, you can touch and you can feel. These parts are known as what? Are these components are known as what? Hardware. Got it? Yes. The next thing, software means what? Software is nothing but it is the set of programs or instructions. That is known as what? Software. It is a set of programs or instructions. It will perform some specific task or multiple task. That is known as what? Software or application. Simply we call software or application. So both hardware and software are interdependent. Okay, without hardware, we can't able to do any work in the computer. And without software, we can't able to do any work in the computer. So both are very important in the computer. So that's why I told both hardware and software is the interdependent component in the machine. Understood? So both hardware and software together, it will make the computer system to function. So that is the main information of computer. Right. So in this components of computer, we have to follow IPO cycle. So what is the meaning of IPO cycle? IPO cycle is nothing but input process output. That is the expansion of IPO. I stands for input, P stands for process, and O stands for output cycle. Okay. So how this cycle should work in the system? It needs certain input, processes that input and produce the desired output. So this is the exact mechanism they have to follow once you do the process in the computer. All right. So how the input should take? The input takes from which unit means input unit. So we have a different types of unit. So this is what input unit, and in center you hold, you know that is what? This is what your CPU, central processing unit. This is called what? CPU, central processing unit. Then finally output unit. In this central processing unit, we have a additional unit is there. We have to see one by one. The first thing is input unit. So input unit is used for what purpose? And central processing is used for what purpose? And control unit will do what action? And finally, output unit have what function? So everything we'll see one by one, right? Yes. The first thing, input unit. So input unit is used to feed any form of data to the computer. So what is the main purpose of input unit? To feed the data. To feed the data or to feed the any form of data. And the data, whatever it is, that data should be to feed inside the computer. So input unit is used to feed any form of data, whether it is text or image or audio or video, whatever it is, any multimedia component form of data you can feed to the computer. That is known as what? Input, which can be stored in the memory unit for what purpose? Further process purpose. So once you want to perform or process anything, first of all, you have to store the data first. Then only it will be process. Okay, so that's very, very important. So what is the main purpose of input unit? It is used to feed any form of data to the computer. By how? By how means with the help of input devices. These are the different types of input devices. These topics we'll see in the upcoming topics, the same chapter. Okay, you don't worry about that. We have to see about these devices one by one. So with the help of different types of input devices, you can feed the data into the computer. Example like keyboard or mouse, these are the different examples of input devices. Okay, right. The next thing is central processing unit. That is very important unit, central processing unit. This is simply called as CPU. All of you know that. Okay, CPU is the major component which interprets and executes software instructions. So what is the main job of CPU means? It interprets and executes software instructions. What is the meaning of interprets? Interprets means it will be performing, okay? It will be execute, it will be process like that, okay? So it will be interprets means it will be process the action or process the input data and execute the software instructions. So that is the main purpose of what? CPU. It also control the overall operations. It also control the operations of all other components. Okay, in your computer, what are the different types of operations? All the operations, it will be controlled like from this unit. This is known as what? CPU. So in this CPU, we have three different types of components. As per the information, we have three different types of components. So these three components are working inside the CPU. Don't forget, my dear students. So inside the CPU, we have additionally three different types of components. Number one, control unit. Number two, arithmetic and logic unit. That is simply we call ALU. And number three, memory unit. So these are the three important components we have in the CPU. Okay, so in this CPU, it accept what? Binary data as input. So whatever the input we have to receive from the user, everything should be considered as what? Binary data. Why? Because system understand only the machine language, not for any other high level language, not for any human language. Machine knows only the machine language. So that machine language should made up of only the numbers, especially binary numbers. That's why we call all the data should be called as binary data. So binary means two, bi means two, right? So one is zero, another one is one. So zeros and ones type of data, it will be considered as input from the user. Then it will be process the data according to the instructions. Whatever the instructions we have to give, as per the instruction, it will be performing the data or process the data. Then finally, it will provide the result as an what? Output. Okay, right. So this is the main working principle of what? CPU. That means central processing unit. Okay, all right. So this is what is this diagram? This is nothing but processor. This processor are very important for doing the same actions. Okay, without this processor, we can't able to do anything in the CPU. Okay, all right. So in this central processing unit, already I told no three different types of components. Number one, arithmetic and logic unit. So in this unit, that is ALU, is the part of CPU. Yeah, already we know that it have various computing functions are performed on data. That is, it will be do various actions or various function will be do. The ALU performs arithmetic operations such as, so what are the different types of arithmetic operations? Or arithmetic operation means what? So what are the actions we'll do under the topic arithmetic operation, such as number one, addition, number two, subtraction, number three, multiplication, number four, division, and then next one is logical operations. Some of the logical operations also we have to do in this ALU unit. So especially ALU is the unit, it will perform both arithmetic operations and also the logical operations. So this result of an operation is stored in the internal memory of CPU. Then automatically it will be performing the actions. And finally, the logic should be control everything. Okay. So logic also you have to apply by the user. Okay. Right. The next thing is control unit. The control unit controls the flow of data between the CPU and memory and input output devices. That means what? This unit especially controls the flow of data between by where to where, from the CPU to memory device and from the memory to input output device. So this is the platform to share the informations or to convey the informations from one part to another part with the help of which unit? control unit. So that's why control unit should control the entire flow of data process. It also control the entire operation of computer also. So all the operations of ALU promote what? Decision making ability of your computer. So which unit will be called as decision making ability of computer? That is known as what? Control unit. Number three, memory unit. So this memory unit is very important to store all the data or instructions or some intermediate result, everything. So if you want to store anything inside the computer, which unit will be the responsible one? That is what? Memory unit. So this unit supplies the information to the other units of computer whenever we need. Okay, so whenever the system need, it should be supply the information from one part to another part. That is the main purpose of what? This memory unit. So these all three components are very, very important for central processing unit. So central processing unit hold three important components. Number one, ALU. Number two, control unit. Number three, yeah, of course, memory unit. All right, fine. The next thing is output unit. These are the third unit, very important unit, output unit. So an output unit is any hardware component that conveys the information to the user for user's understandable form. In the very beginning, we just discussed about input unit, right? So what is the purpose of input unit? We just feed the data. What data? Any form of data. You just feed the any form of data to the computer. That is the purpose of what? Input unit. The same thing. In output unit, it just convey the information after performing all the actions. Finally, it will be produced the result, right? So that result we have to convey to the user in what form? Understandable form, human understandable form. Just like that, this unit should be performing. These are the different types of output devices. With the help of these output devices, the information, the processed information should be conveyed to the user in the understandable form. Example like monitor or printer, etc., etc., like that. Okay, so these also, these, what are the different types of output devices? We have to see one by one in the upcoming topic also. All right, the next unit is memory unit. This is the final unit of computer. So already we discussed about various units like input unit, central processing unit, and output unit also. The final unit is memory unit. It is a very important unit. This unit especially is used for what purpose? Means it just store the information inside the computer. So in the computer, whatever the data you have to feed, whatever the data you have to process, whatever the result you can store, everything you have to store in the memory. That is very important. Without memory unit, we can't able to store anything, and also we can't able to view anything. So that's why I told this unit is very, very important. So especially this memory unit, we have two different types. Number one, that is primary memory, and number two, secondary memory. So what is primary memory and what is secondary memory? We will see one by one. The primary memory is used to store the programs temporarily and data when the instructions are ready to execute. So for what purpose we have to use this memory? It is used to store the programs and data temporarily when the instructions are ready to execute. So whenever we want to execute anything, or whenever the execution process are ready to do that, that time the programs and data should be stored temporarily. Then only the execution process will be start. So without storing means we can't able to do any execution process. So that is the main purpose of what? This primary memory. So the next thing is secondary memory. So what is that meaning? Secondary memory is used to store the data permanently. So what is the main difference of both primary and secondary memory? Primary memory to store the data temporarily, but the secondary memory is used to store the data permanently. And another point, the primary memories are volatile. Volatile means what? We can't able to, for example, whenever the data should be processed or performing anything in the sense, it will be not storing permanently. So this is not a permanent one or not a constant. It will be like a temporary only, right? So that's why we call this is what? Volatile memory. So which memory is a volatile memory? It is primary memory, okay? And the next thing is secondary memory is a non-volatile memory. This is another point of both primary and secondary memory. So secondary memory is a non-volatile because whenever the data should be processed, that time we have any facing any problem in the sense the data should not loss. But in the primary memory, the data should be loss. Okay, that information is already I told in the paragraph. So the primary memories are volatile. Why? Because the contents should be loss when the power supply is switched off. Okay, so which one is called as a primary memory means RAM. Simply we call as what? RAM. Don't pronounce like ROM. This is what? RAM. RAM is nothing but random access memory. It is an example of main memory. Main memory as well as primary memory, right? The next thing is the secondary memory is a non-volatile type. Why? Because the content is available even after the power supply is switched off. Understood? So what is the example of secondary memory like hard disk, CD-ROM or DVD-ROM? These are the examples of what memory? Secondary memory. Understood? So these are the difference between both primary and secondary memory. These are the memory parts are available in the memory unit. So right from the beginning, we are discussed about different types of units in the computer. Right from the beginning, number one is input unit. Number two is central processing unit. In this central processing unit, we have three different types of components. Number one, arithmetic and logic unit. Number two, control unit. Number three, memory unit. Okay. And the next main unit is what? Output unit. Okay. So in this CPU, we have different types of unit. So right from the beginning, number one, control, number one, ALU, number two, control, and number three, memory. Right. So these are the informations of different types of unit in the computer. Right. The next topic is, this is example of memory unit. This is what? RAM. This is a primary memory, right? And these two will be considered as CD-ROM or DVD-ROM. And this is what? Hard disk. So these both the disk and these hard disk, these are the examples of secondary memory. This only is the example of primary memory. This name is what? RAM, random access memory. Why? Because this is volatile and this is non-volatile. Okay, right.